Hey guys, this is Steve with RockTape. We're gonna be doing the final open wad, 13.5, with Shannon. She's gonna help us out to figure out what RockTape applications are gonna help you out for this wad. We're gonna start off, just like last week, working on hands. Again, we're gonna show these great pads that we're gonna try to protect and into the middle of the palm. So we're gonna do three things. We're gonna take a measurement first, taking the actual width of the tape around to the wrist. This is the most important part. We're gonna fold it in half and just very lightly take a small slither of tape off just like that. So when I open this up, it's gonna create a nice circle that I can place a finger through. So I'm gonna peel the paper backing and have you expose the one hand, and we're just gonna feed that over, leave that down, and I'm just gonna have her open the hand up nice and wide. Just gonna fan that down so it goes over top of the wrist. Flip that hand over. And just make sure it's nice and flat. We'll do the second piece, same measurement. Hope you turn that hand the other way, like that. I'm gonna fold it in half once again. As close as we can get. We're gonna take a nice thin, thin slice off of that. Again, opening it up and creating that equal circle. Open that hand up again. So I'm just pulling the paper backing back like that. I'm gonna extend that over. Now this will be on a diagonal. I'm going to open up the hand nice and wide and lay that down over the hand into the wrist. Flip that hand around, and same thing with this one, just fanning it out. And those are the ones for the hand. We can close that, close the open end by taking the one piece. I usually round the edges. It limits it from catching on anything. We're going to break this one right in the middle. Peel the paper back, have you make a fist for me, and then put it up against my chest. And we're just gonna wrap that wrist and then finish off the other one. And you can go as tight or as loose as you need to be. And then have you open that hand up, especially that side, and you can see all the sensitive areas are being protected through any of those lifts. That's number one. Number two, we're gonna do a lower back taping to protect. I'm gonna have you turn around. So we can protect the lower back and the SI joint and the bottom end of the thrusters. So I'm gonna get her, we wanna get it under stretch first. I'm gonna have her put her elbows up on the table here for me. So there's the stretch. I'm gonna make a measurement from the SI joint to the upper portion of the lumbar spine of the lower back and cut two pieces. I'm gonna round the edges. They're just stacked on top of each other. So we're gonna break the tape, peel off the paper backing so I have it exposed, and I get to the SI joint, or that joint right on the pelvis, and I'm gonna roll this upper back. Second one, we're gonna peel the paper backing off, expose the adhesive, right on that SI joint again, and then on the other side of the back, pulling up to match the other side. That's number two. And then one more, I'm gonna have you face this way, so turn around, have you have a seat on the table. So any way that you can get the leg into stretch, I'm gonna have her pull her foot back to stretch the quad out. This is gonna help the bottom end of the thruster to help offload the quad. We're gonna take a measurement just above the kneecap to the top of the thigh, two strips of tape for that. Same thing around the edges. Put it under stretch, paper backing off. Take it just above the kneecap, and then rolling that up while the thigh is under stretch, all the way up to the top of the thigh. And last one, have you bend that. This one I'm gonna do a peel back method. Right above the kneecap, I'm just gonna roll that up. I'm using the paper backing to help guide me all the way to the top. And those are the three RockTape applications for 13.5. You guys are done. Go out there and have some fun, Greg.